Good morning, everyone. This is Fox and Friends.
In 2005, former Miss America Gretchen Carlson joined Fox News, famous for its conservative views, and established herself as a familiar face over the next 11 years, despite some questionable moments.
Would you like to correct yourself on that other talking point about men being dominant?
Oh, we don't have any time.
That was beautiful. You look beautiful.
Well,
thank you.
Look fabulous, too.
Women are everywhere. We're letting them play golf and tennis now. It's out of control.
You know what?
You know?
Behind the scenes, things were even tougher. And in 2016, Gretchen went public with allegations of sexual harassment against her Fox News boss, the infamous Roger Ailes, claiming she'd been fired after refusing his sexual advances.
Now she's speaking out against her former boss, claiming he subjected her to severe and pervasive sexual harassment and sabotaged her career.
Carlson was successful in her lawsuit, ending Roger Ailes' career, receiving more than $26 million and an apology from Fox.
That feeling, that burn, it doesn't go away.
Gretchen's story was hot property in Hollywood, being played by our Naomi Watts in The Loudest Voice and our Nick in the Oscar-winning film Bombshell.
Someone has to speak up. Someone has to get mad.
Gretchen, thanks so much for joining us on the project.
Thanks for having me, Lisa.
Your experience at Fox News at the hands of Roger Ailes is one of a significant handful that laid the foundation for the Me Too movement. 5 or so years on, how much progress do you think has been made?
Immense progress. I just passed bipartisan legislation here in the US to eradicate one of the silencing mechanisms that has kept issues like harassment secret, something called forced arbitration clauses in employment contracts here in America predominantly. But this was the biggest labor law change in the last 100 years. This affects millions of workers here and will make it so that they don't have to go into secrecy anymore. I consider it my greatest life achievement other than my 2 children.
That's a great life achievement or set of life achievements to have. Now, Gretchen, you signed an NDA that I know prevents you speaking in detail about your experiences at Fox News. Why did you do that?
Because at the time, how would I have known that I would be part of a movement? How would I have known that my case would help ignite an international movement that we now call Me Too? At the time, my settlement with Fox News and the parent company and with Roger Ailes was progressive. I got a public apology. That never happens. I also got the ability to talk about the issue of harassment, which I have taken full advantage of in trying to make workplaces safer for everyone. But the NDA to me at the time was, well, you got to just sign this because this is how it works.
Gretchen, I can't even begin to imagine the courage it must have taken for you to speak out against someone as powerful as Roger Ailes. He was your boss. What's your advice to other women in other workplaces facing similar situations that you were in who are considering speaking out?
Yeah, I always say to them, so many of them reach out to me and I try to get back to each and every one of them, including many women from Australia. And I always tell them that it's a personal choice because we are still in an era of retaliation. And coming forward takes immense courage, and it may mean the loss of your job or your career. And the more women that do come forward, the more we can work to change that. So I try and line them up with lawyers. I try to line them up with members of the media if they want to get their story out. And then the ultimate decision for them is a personal one based on where they are and whether or not they know the ramifications that might be if they do come forward.
Did you ever see Roger Ailes again?
Oh, God, no. That would have been a nightmare. And, you know, he died soon thereafter, within a year of my case. And so, you know, no, I never saw him or obviously spoke to him again. I just saw his signature on my settlement agreement.
What was that moment like?
It was, incredibly powerful for me to see in my mind that he had admitted to it and acquiesced.
You recently slammed Fox News, saying that they were perpetuating an outright dangerous rhetoric. Can you talk me through what you were referring to there?
Yes, I mean, I believe Fox News has completely changed since even I was there almost 6 years ago now. Really, the President Trump era, you know, changed dramatically how Fox News went from simply opinion to buying into many of the lies that were perpetuated by the former president, including the January 6th insurrection. And there's, you know, there's a huge difference between opinion television and lying. I'm wholeheartedly in favor of people being able to have their opinions, but this is different.
Do you think Trump is on his way back?
Oh gosh, I have no opinion on that other than I was not surprised when he ran for president the first time. And I was one of the few journalists that actually said that he was probably serious about it and probably actually had a chance of winning. But that was only because I had interviewed him countless times over 30 years. And I knew what a master marketer he was, even if he always wasn't telling the truth.
Gretchen, on the big screen, of course, your story and you have been played by two of our favourite Australian actors, Nicole Kidman and Naomi Watts. Do you have a preference? Which one do you think nailed you more?
Well, ironically, Lisa, I can't tell you because of my NDA. I cannot even tell you if their portrayals of me were accurate, nor could I participate in either project. I will share with you that I have become friends with Naomi Watts. We happened to meet each other at the premiere and embraced, and it felt like kismet because she had studied who I was so intently. And I knew that she had done that. And it was almost like we didn't have to share any words with one another. And I would love to meet Nicole Kidman to share that same exact moment. But look, the fact that these two brilliant actresses decided to take on this role of playing Gretchen Carlson, like, that's surreal to me. And I'm just so happy that they put themselves out there, because 6 years ago, nobody would have taken on these roles. They would not have been making movies about sexual harassment in the workplace. And I'm grateful to both of them for using their talents to shine a light on this issue.
We're going to be seeing you here in Australia in just a few weeks for the Vivid Festival. Tell me, what's the first thing you're going to do when you get off the plane here in Australia?
Oh, my gosh. I'm so excited because I've never been to Australia. And I'm going to be with my 19-year-old daughter. So it's going to be amazing to share this festival with her. And but I'm just really, really excited to see the beautiful harbor and take it all in. And just so blessed that Vivid invited me to come and share my story and hopefully to inspire so many other people in Sydney and everywhere else.
Well, Gretchen, we can't wait to see you down here in Australia. And thank you again for everything that you've done.
Thank you so much for having me.
She has become such a significant figure in everything that's been happening to women over the last 5 years or so. And I'm so grateful to her for being so honest. And she's going to be even more honest when I'm in conversation with her at Vivid Festival in Sydney on May the 29th. If you'd like to get tickets, all you have to do is head to our website for more details.